crisis of December 2008, November, December 2008, was the most serious crisis to hit the capitalist world since the Great Depression of 1929. They have managed to control its consequences by what? By using the state, which ideologically they are supposed to hate. Because if you look at neoliberal policy and the meaning of neoliberalism, the market is God. The market knows better than everything else. The market will decide what is best for our country and for the world. That was the Washington Consensus, which Fernando Henrique implemented in Brazil so beautifully, deindustrializing the country. Now, that system has collapsed. But instead of looking for new ways, they use the state to maintain that system by pouring in millions and billions of dollars all over the world to save the banks. Why? Why? If the market is so beautiful, yeah. If it's so beautiful, the market, let it do its business. But they can't afford that because their credibility and their economy is at stake. And today in the United States, you have 14 million newly unemployed people. 14 million. You have the houses of many people being taken back by the mortgage companies. That the state doesn't stop. But in terms of helping the banks, it helped them. So the crisis is not over. It is not over, and it's a big, big mistake to think that the crisis is over. It is there. Just recently, as I came from Europe, a whole country, another country, Ireland, had collapsed. And the Irish elite, instead of saying, okay, we are going to try again without you, we are going to get out of Europe, we don't want to be part of the Euro world, and we will try to rebuild our country, said, no, 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 please give us money, please give us money. So they have now sold themselves. It's useless to talk about the independence of Greece and Ireland. They are owned mainly by German banks now and a few British banks, and Britain itself is in a big crisis, but they can find 9 billion. They say that Britain says, the British elite, we're in a terrible crisis. We have to spend less on education, less on health, less on welfare benefit. But suddenly Ireland collapses. Ah, you want 9 billion? Here's 9 billion. So it's a real crisis for these countries. The problem is there's no organized opposition. That's the problem. So that is what people, you know, are paralyzed. They just feel there's nothing we can do.